Daniel Andrews has tested negative to COVID despite attending a 50th birthday with a confirmed case. Thousands of pub and restaurant bookings are being cancelled as Victorians try to avoid Christmas in isolation. Adam Hegarty with the latest.
On the dance floor of a swanky high society birthday bash, all the hallmarks of a COVID spreading event. A Saturday night 50th at the Earlwood Bathers for a close friend of the Premier's wife. Someone in the building had COVID. Dan Andrews was there, but after testing negative, he's free of isolation.
When we're advised to get tested, we go and get tested because that's the right thing to do.
A stark contrast to the plight of patrons and staff from the Peel Hotel. 16 cases now linked to a night out, and because so far one's confirmed to be Omicron, all are still isolating for 7 days, including the owner, even though he's tested negative too.
I do feel, again, that we're supposed to be living with this. So overall, I don't think it's fair.
And people are nervous. Restaurants reporting some are cancelling or moving bookings, frightened they'll need to isolate for Christmas.
A number of them are moving them to sort of February, March, even late January, where circumstances will be a little bit clearer.
Omicron is new to Australia and Victoria, and we will continue to take the advice from our health experts on how best to respond.
As the new variant spreads, 1,510 cases in Victoria, but no longer the epicentre. In New South Wales, more than 2,200, an unprecedented 64 in SA, 20 in Queensland, as it brings back masks, and the NT has locked down Tennant Creek, the severity of Omicron, to determine where to from there.
What's important is we keep our heads, we keep calm, we keep open, we keep healthy, and we keep getting vaccinated.
The Royal Exhibition Centre not closing after all. Instead, tonight it ramps up for a pre-Christmas booster blitz.
And live now to Adam Hegarty in South Melbourne. Adam, there's been lengthy waits at some testing sites.
Alicia, absolutely. It's looking pretty bare on the road here at South Melbourne behind me, but that's actually because they've started turning cars away for the final hour of operation at this particular testing site. The wait time a few moments ago was upwards of an hour and 30 minutes. Meanwhile, have a look at these pictures from other testing sites across Melbourne today. The worst we've heard was a wait time of upwards of 5 hours for some people, fueled, we're told, predominantly by people having to get a test within 72 hours of travelling interstate for Christmas plans. And that comes amid a big, big change for Victoria and New South Wales for overseas travel, Melbourne and Sydney. If there's an overseas arrival here, they've scrapped the rule for 72-hour quarantine at least. Instead, Alicia, it'll just need to be getting a test within a day.
OK, Adam Hegarty, thank you.